Hey everyone, Balint from SEON here. As you know, we love continuously optimizing our tool to make fraud fighting a lot easier for you guys. This includes polishing our features and refining our algorithms. Now, I'm coming with a fantastic update about the new dashboard release that we have. Let's take a look at what this entails exactly. Firstly, you can see the announcements widget right here, which contains all the important news about releases we have. Now, some specific examples like the new Bin API, custom lists, and the device fingerprinting rules. You have all seen and heard these, possibly from my team, but you will also see these here in this widget. Secondly, we're looking at the top locations, where you have a map view of all the transactions, the approve and the decline ones. You can switch between these by clicking this button. And then you can see which country the transactions are coming from that are either in the approve or the decline states. Now, one additional note which makes these widgets much better is that all of them are filterable. So you can select the time frame that you want. This can be either the predefined ones or custom timeframes as well, which you can see right here. Then you can define what action type you want to be looking at, as well as the payment modes, the countries the users are from, as well as brand IDs and currencies. This is available for all the widgets that you have. Now, a good old favorite of mine, the transactions widget, which allows you to look at the distribution of transactions across a specific time period. And you can, of course, define this as per your requirements. An additional note, which I always use for this widget, you can lock your filters. So if there's something that you very often want to be looking at, then you can just save that view for yourself and utilize it in your future endeavors against those pesky fraudsters. Secondly, then we have the transaction labels widget, where you can see when you are applying or your team is applying specific widgets, whether it's about chargeback, bonus abuse, or even whatever additional label you define. And then an important change to make finding the important statistics even easier for you, we have added the applied rule statistics widget right to the dashboard. Now, this is extremely important because using this, you are able to detect and stop very specific fraud attacks and peaks in your traffic. I'm looking at an example where the time zone, based on the IP geolocation as well as the device checks, is different, which can indicate multiple different suspicious behaviors. And as you can see, there are two peaks right here in February. So as a fraud analyst, I would notice that, okay, something crazy must have been going on there and jump on over there to check the affected transactions. And then we have the team activity widget, where you can review what your team is doing and how many transactions they are processing through SEON. This is available in this nice widget view as all the other statistics, and you can view the last 5 actions that your team did as well. And lastly, the good old state threshold widget. Of course, this allows you to see the distribution of transactions with specific scores from 0 to 100, like you're used to. I hope you're going to like all of these features. Please contact us if we can help you even further. Have a great day!